If you get the message that Safari cannot open the page because it could not connect to the server, then the first thing that you have to do is you have to check if there is internet connection in your phone or not. You can open any other websites, or you can open a YouTube video to check if it opens or not. The next thing that you can do is you can restart your router and restart your iPhone too. Sometimes simply restarting the router and iPhone fixes the issue. Then the other thing that you will do is you will go to settings, you will go to Safari, then you will scroll down, and if you see there is an option here, block all cookies, you can disable this option to check if this will fix the issue or not. After that, the other thing that you can do is you can clear the history and data. So go here and then you can tap on this option, clear history and data, to check if this will fix the issue or not. Also, you can go down and go to this advanced option here, go to website data, and if there are datas here, you can delete them by tapping on edit button, and then you can delete the website data if it is present here. For me, it's not present, so I don't need to delete it. Also, go back and make sure that this option JavaScript is enabled for the Safari browser. Now the other thing that you can do is you can go to settings, you can go to general, go to transfer or reset iPhone, select reset, and select this option reset network settings. It will reset all the settings related to Wi-Fi data, mobile and Bluetooth. So you have to again use the password of Wi-Fi to connect to the Wi-Fi network. Check if after this the issue is fixed or not. Now the last thing that you will check is make sure that there is correct date and time in your iPhone. If the date and time is not correct, then Safari cannot connect to the server. There won't be a secure connection. So go to the settings, go to general, go to date and time, and make sure that you have selected this option set automatically, so that the time in your phone will be set according to the SIM card that you have used. If the date and time won't be set correctly by selecting this option set automatically, then in that case you can disable it, and then you can manually adjust the time. So do all of these things and hopefully Safari can connect to the server, or it can open the website to which you want to connect. Thank you for watching this video. Please like and share this video if you found it helpful. Also click on the subscribe button and hit on the bell icon to get the notification of our latest videos for free.